at that time itself, I thought that, you know, mind mapping the entire book creates a summary of the book.
Okay.
And it's a bit of a hard work, but once you have done it, and mind you, it's a book that you want to understand better. I mean, you want to reread again and again. So once you create the mind map, actually what you have done is you have created a summary of the book. And once you have done that, it's just a, you know, you can read the entire, it's like you have created a situation where you read the entire book in a few minutes.
Right.
And so the same concept I have used. In fact, as I said earlier, you know, the mind maps were already there chapter-wise.
Yes.
And in I created a section of for mind maps, because mind map was an alien concept for most of my readers. So I had to talk about what mind maps were, how I, you know, how they are useful, and, you know. So in that, I also have talked about, you know, why I am putting those mind maps there. And the instruction to the reader was read the entire book first. And whenever okay. there are relevant points that you want to, or relevant chapters that you want to go through, then second time reading need not be a whole reading of the text. You just refer to the mind map. A glance at the mind map will give you all the points.